Hi, welcome to Heartfully Creating. It's going to be a Brighten Up the Neighbourhood segment where I decided to paint some things that are on the outside of our home, kind of like a practical art project, and that would be our mailbox that I need to refinish. About 17 years ago, my mom and Craig built this wooden mailbox for our new home, and I decided it was time to redo it. I used some Pebeo acrylic paint that I set out in a plastic palette, and I did use some gesso or white paint mixture to create a background, got some ideas, doodled them down, doesn't mean I stick to them. And this is how bad the other one looked. It had been weathered, so I started painting it and layer by layer to cover up the old. I got Craig to just, my husband, to just sand down the surface because the wood kind of rippled, the paint rippled and was peeling. It's endured, like you said, almost about 17 years of outdoor weathering. So I painted the inside and the outside. I didn't worry at all about what the inside looks like, but I just kept painting. And you want to have a good foundation if you're going to paint something on top. I used acrylic, but then after I did use polyurethane or polycrylic is the brand that I use to coat it and seal it all in. A couple of good coats, probably more. So once I got through that point, I had my ideas, got my paint palette ready. You don't have to use Pebeo, it just happened to be, I swiped some of my husband's that I got from and took out my ideas and then started to sketch them out in the best way that I thought possible on the mailbox. So composition is important to me. I'm not saying it's a great composition, but how the overall picture looks, whether it's on a mailbox, whether it's on a canvas, whatever. So I just want to make it interesting and not boring. For me, I do have some arm muscle weakness, so it's tricky trying to elevate my arm to get at it. So I had to kind of prop it down on the table and get my husband to help me move it around sometimes because it was a bit heavy. And then I started laying it down, and my butterflies in no way, shape, or form are supposed to be monarch butterflies, just sort of giving the essence of a butterfly. So when you're drawing, you don't have to do anything perfect. You can give the idea of it or whatever you want, abstract it. It can be non-representational art, whatever. And I wanted to have fun, so I had the caterpillar, got ladybug. Sorry if these aren't in the exact order. My problem is I am bad at taking so many pictures that when I load them into my computer, they seem to be a little shuffled and mixed up. And so I'm trying to put them in order. But yeah, so it doesn't always work out that right. Because it's nice to, I guess if I loaded it step by step, but I just did it. And then I lay it down, I put like a big, just layered it, and then I want the detail and I want depth, and which depth for me is using shading, lights and darks and all that's in between. And I think I talked about that not long ago. That really helps create depth, is if you just, and it's a totally different technique. If you want to leave something flat, that's fine. If you don't want to use lights and darks and everything in between, then that's up to you. But for me, I just like to create interest and depth. And that for me, if you look at some of the flowers and whatnot and the butterflies, you'll see that some areas, I even started in some cases, at one point I thought, hey, it looks good. I think I'm done. And then I keep working it. And that's another problem I have, is sometimes I don't know when to quit. I don't know if you have that problem or not. I would love to hear from you if you do. Is it just me, where you go over the line and you could have quit and you could have been done and it would have been a great piece of art, but then you just keep going? So it's not that I don't like the finished product, but in the end, I don't know, just looking at the pictures as I reminisce, because this is a little bit late, sorry guys, and actually as I do this, I just think about my poor mom who's been in the hospital and with some bone fractures due to osteoporosis. So please pray for her. And yeah, she helped Craig, my husband, build this. So, and I did the painting. So I retweaked it. And my mom is a flower in my life. And this whole COVID thing, not allowed to visit her. Thankfully, my dad can. But yeah, you can't even. And it's restricted visiting hours to boot. But at least he can. Because at one point when this whole thing started, nobody could visit anybody in the hospital. And that was just, seniors facilities and whatnot, which was really sad. So I worked on the ladybug and I did the the layers and my palette, you could tell. The messier it gets, the more... I love color mixing. And then I wanted to put a Bible verse on, so I did that. And, yeah, so I'll just stop, because then I continued when I was actually in process with this other little short clip here.
Okay, I'm done. And now, well, almost done. I still got to put the Bible verse on the back that I was going to put. I'm just putting polyurethane. And Craig's talking to me, getting ready for other things. I'm done.
So that mailbox took me a while. I did take other videos along the way, but like I said, I got them a little bit muddled. So then I took some shots outside once it was all set up, and Craig screwed it into the deck railing. So I hope you enjoy. I hope you're inspired to create your own mailbox. And back to another in-process video right now.
And here is the other side of the mailbox, all screwed in and ready for the letter carrier. In our case, we have a mailman. Okay, and here's the other side of the mailbox, all done. Of course, I could have spent a lot more time tweaking it, but it's Monday and the letter mail's coming, so I had to go.
Thank you for watching, and I would love to hear from you if you've ever made your own mailbox or painted a mailbox or a ready-made mailbox. Just remember to coat it with something that's weatherproof to help it last. Have a great weekend, guys. And remember, if you liked the video, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, or like, share, and subscribe. Or you don't have to. It's up to you. But it really helps my channel. The more subscribers I get, eventually I can make maybe a dollar or something. I don't know. To help pay for some of the supplies, but I don't expect anyone to pay for anything or help support that in that way, just because I'm choosing to make these videos because I like doing it a lot. Oh, I love doing it. So happy creating.